has ignited. The first stage's main objective is really to get the Dragon spacecraft out of the atmosphere, which it is doing. The second stage is now its mission to deliver the Dragon into its specific orbit. What you're seeing on the screen right now is our tracking cameras really working to follow that first stage back as it returns to the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. So the boost back burn is complete. There are at least a couple more burns required to get that first stage back down here to the Earth, which we'll keep a close eye on. So as you're seeing, again, everything so far proceeding as expected, is what we refer to as nominal, which is everything we would like to see today. But there's still a good bit of work yet to be done, but a lot under our belt. So Daryl, we're going to actually go back to you, and this is going to be signing off from the Mission Director Center. Thanks for being with me, and we'll see you next time.
Scott Santora, live in the Mission Control Center. Thank you for taking us through the launch. And as the rocket continues to above now, we are now going to switch gears and monitor the Dragon spacecraft during the International Space Station, but also get this exciting moment for this mission, and that's the return of SpaceX's booster to Landing Zone 1, which is just about 10 miles to the southeast of where I am located here at the Kennedy Space Center. Let's bring in Alex Spiegel of SpaceX back in. He's out in California at the company's headquarters to show us the landing and talk about reflying that Dragon spacecraft. Alex.
Thank you, Daryl. Now, for those of you just joining us, we may have said it before, but this is SpaceX's 20th launch of 2018, and we're launching a flight-proven Dragon spacecraft today, which visited the International Space Station once before for our CRS-10 mission, all the way back in March of 2017. You can hear some applause behind us, but they're doing some great. Both Falcon 9 and Dragon were designed with reflight in mind, so the vehicle hardware is built to support multiple missions with minimal refurbishment in between. And while this Dragon has flown once before, the booster we're flying today is actually brand new. And in just a few moments, we'll be bringing that first stage back to land and landing Zone 1 at Cape Canaveral so that it can fly again on future missions. Now, in order to make its way back to the landing zone, the first stage executes a series of three burns. The first is a boost back burn, which helps slow the rocket down horizontally. Shortly after this burn is initiated, the grid which you see right on your screen, located near the top of the first stage, are deployed, and they help guide the rocket during descent. Following the boost back burn, Falcon 9 executes a re-entry burn to slow itself down before hitting the dense part of the atmosphere. Watch the action for a moment. So right now we're looking at the second stage, and you're looking at that MVAC-D primary mission here. We still have the Dragon capsule headed to the space station. It is a bummer that we weren't able to capture an